In this video, we are going to do mail merge. I have data in Excel. These are the four people I intend to recruit, and I want to send each one of them an email with all the details about recruitment. I'll create the letter in Word and mail it to them. This is one common mail merge scenario. There are two other scenarios. One is where I need to attach a separate file for each person. I also need to put some people in CC. I have a separate video for that. Another common requirement is I get a lot of data which pertains to multiple people, and then I want to split the data by person or entity and send a mail to each person showing only their own data. I have a separate video for this scenario as well. Now let's focus on this simple mail merge. First step is to prepare the data. I have it in Excel. You will notice that there are two columns, salary and MM salary. MM means for mail merge. Similarly, I have date of joining and MM date of joining. So why do I have two columns like this? Because the formatting which we apply in Excel does not go to Word. So if you want to freeze the formatting, it's best to add another column, and whatever formatting you want, you put it here. I want the prefix INR, and then I want two decimals and a comma. All that I'm doing here. So I'm going to use the MM salary and MM DOJ for actual mail merge. I'm going to mail this to people. So I need a column containing everyone's email ID and an additional column called status. And I want to send this mail only to people whose appointment is already approved. The pending ones I will skip. The next step, we will select the data and give it a name. It's called named range. After selecting, go to this name box, click there and give it a name. No spaces. Press enter. Save the file. Close the file. Now let's go to Word and start the mail merge process. Mail merge happens from here. The first step is to inform Word that I'm starting mail merge, and the output I want it as email messages. The next step is to select where the data comes from. So select the Excel file we just created. Don't select the sheet. Select the range which we created. And of course, our first row does contain headers. You can look at it by saying edit. The page is blank right now, so we'll create the form later. We are going to say dear, and now I want the name of the person. Now I want to inform the person about the appointment, and then I want the designation and department, which I will fill in later. And then I'll put the number and I'll put the date. That's the form of the letter. Now I want to fill in the blanks. So we again go to the mailings area. Position the cursor where you want to fill in the blanks. These are called merge fields. Merge fields come from the columns of our data. So dear name, you have been appointed as what? The designation, then comma, I'll put manually, space, and then the department. Salary is, we have already figured out, not the base salary field, the mail merge salary field, which we have formatted properly, and mail merge version of date of joining. That's all there is to it. Now I'm going to look at, is it working properly? Preview results. So it goes to the first row, looks at it. I can move across rows and see what is happening. Now I want to actually send the mail. Here I can just create the documents or print them directly or send email messages. We'll choose the email option. It needs the column which contains the email ID, which in our case is email, subject line. And now I want to send it as email. Mail format is HTML, which is fine. In some cases, the content we want to send as attachment, in which case you do this. Plain text is rarely used because there'll be no formatting. Now, do we want to do it for all records, current record, or a set of records? That's up to you. So when I click OK, it's going to talk to my Outlook on desktop and do the mail merge. And if I go to my outbox right now, you can see that each one has got an email, and that is how you do mail merge. I'm going to save this document as appointment letter mail merge template so that I can reuse it in future. There are some rules available. For example, we had a column called status. Only those which are approved I want to manage. So I'm going to say skip the record if it is not approved. So if status is not equal to then skip it. How do I check whether this is working? Again, I'm going to finish and merge. This time, instead of sending mails, I'm going to say edit individual documents. Now, what does it do? It creates a new document. It's called electronic messages one, and it has multiple pages. Each page will contain one person or one row. And you'll notice that the row for Raj was not included because that record is not approved. Record and sequence just put a number. So again, I'm going to put for demo purpose record followed by merge record number. And it's like a running total. This is not generated now. It's generated at the time of running the mail merge. So I'm going to create individual letters, all of them. Now you see record one, sequence one, record two, sequence two, record four, because three was skipped, but sequence wise it is three. These can be used for generating invoice numbers and stuff like that. Now here is another idea. If I want to specify some text based on some condition, how do I go about doing it? If the salary is above a limit, I want to deduct some tax. I'm going to put a rule here, if then else. I'm going to choose if the salary is greater than, then we are going to say, and otherwise, okay, let's see, edit individual documents, all. And here, because this is not more than 3 lakhs, it's no tax deduction. This one, 5% tax will be deducted. So we got conditional output as well. Whenever we put these things, you will notice that if you're not in the preview mode, you will see these like this. If you click inside, you will see a gray highlight. These are called fields. If you press Alt F9, you will actually see the fields. And these are like formulas which are being executed or calculated at runtime, and that's how it works. So notice we had said skip the record if it is not approved. This is how it translates behind the scene. Next, let's look at fill in. It's quite simple. At the end of the mail, I want to put some simple message, but I don't want the same message. I want to change it for every candidate. So I'm going to ask what is the message, which is the prompt. And if I want, I can put default text. Click OK. And this is a sample. Now, when I actually do the mail merge for every record, it is going to ask me. The default will come anyway. This is for the first one, the second one, the next one, and fourth one I'll use the default. This is how fill works. If I want to ask for something once and use it multiple times in the mail merge in the same mail, then I have to choose bookmark. So first I will use ask, and I'll give a name, bookmark BM, and I'll still ask the message. Now notice it did not put it anywhere. Wherever I actually want to put the text of the bookmark, I have to press enter, press Ctrl F9, say reference, and then give the name of the bookmark, BM. I'm putting it in two different places. Another way to do it is go to Insert, Quick Parts, Field, Search for Ref, and choose the bookmark. Now let's run the mail merge and see what happens. First, I will use the default. For second record, I'll just say 22. For third, I'll say 33. Fourth, I'll say 44. So this is the default message. Came twice. Second record was 22, and so on. So that is how you use the ask rule. So I hope now you understand how to prepare data for mail merge, how to create the letter, how to fill in the fields, how to use different rules, and create mail merge in various ways. Please share this with as many people as you can, because this is a very powerful feature. It has been there for decades, but many people still don't know it, and they're wasting their life doing this manually. So let's make the world a more efficient place together. That's it for now. Thank you. See you next time.